For today, I'm doing a tempura squash with bagoong dressing. So I'm starting with the barbecued shrimp first because it takes the longest to cook. I really want to build flavor in the broth. So what I did was gather all of the shells, including the tails. I removed the head because they have a lot of flavor, but sometimes they discolor the broth and I don't really want that. So we're going to toast up the shells, really bring out their flavors. And then we're going to add in a bunch more stuff. I want this broth to really bring out the sweetness of the shrimp. I'm going to add in a lot of spices. So I'm going to start with some cayenne pepper. Okay, a lot of heat. And then some thyme. So remember, whenever you're using dried herbs, you want to crush it a little bit. Just to make sure it releases some of its oils. A little bit of dried oregano. And then lots of paprika. I want that nice smoky taste. And then some garlic powder. Nice big pinch of that as well. You just have to watch for the shells to change colors. And then you want to add in your liquids. Now you don't want to burn the shells. So I'm going to add in some wine. So any kind of white wine or rice wine will do. Okay, and as that is reducing, I'm going to chop up some garlic just to give it some nice aromatic flavor. And maybe some onions because it's here. Aroma is really nice right now. It smells like shrimp stewing, and that is just going to enhance the shrimp flavor once we cook it. Now I'm going to add in some Worcestershire sauce. I love this sauce. It's aged in barrels, so it's slightly fermented. You get a nice umami flavor. And at the same time, there's flavors of tamarind in there, so I don't know, it's a British sauce, but feels a little bit Filipino to me, right? With the tamarind. Nice. Now we're gonna add in our water. Excellent. Okay, so this is gonna go in and simmer for maybe about 15 to 20 minutes, but if you've got the time, and I think I do, this can go on for about half an hour just to really get all those flavors together. So meanwhile, I'm just gonna tidy up and move on my other dish, which is the tempura squash. But before anything else, I'm going to keep the shrimp in the fridge just to keep it fresh. I thought of using squash because there's a ton of squash at the market. Everybody seems to want to use it, but whenever I ask them about it, they always say that they cook pinakbet. So I figured maybe if we serve something different, maybe it'll be more exciting. The thinner your slice, the quicker it's going to cook as a tempura. And the key to a really good tempura is to just fry it really quickly and take it out so that it's very crispy. Okay, so the oil is going to be hot in no second. Here, I've got the broth just simmering away. That smell is intoxicating. And for me, you know, rice flour isn't really a necessity. I mean, usually when you talk tempura, it's always rice flour. For me, I don't always have rice flour at home. So I'm just going to use all-purpose flour, which you probably should have at home all the time anyway. So this is something I learned from Nora Daz's cookbook, actually, to add a little bit of cornstarch to your tempura. It does help make the batter a little bit lighter. Of course, an egg. Okay, the last thing we need is ice water. I really want to tell you what the scientific reaction is with cold water and batters, but I really can't. But what I'm going to tell you is if you add ice water, it's going to make it a lot crunchier. And since this is a batter, as with any batter, you know, pancakes, crepes, you don't really have to beat it to death. You know, just mix it you know, in a really chill manner, like you're not angry at it. This looks pretty nice. So what I like to do is I like to stick my finger in it, right? And then check it out. See if it coats your finger in a very light manner, then you know that the batter is perfect. When you want to check the oil and you don't have an oil thermometer, I always say just stick some wooden thing in there, and if the bubbles start forming around, then it's ready. Like that. Okay, so I just let the tempura squash lie on a paper towel just to drain any of the excess oil. But if fried properly at a really high temperature, there's very little oil that's gonna come out. Now, we're gonna do the dressing. And it's a very, very simple dressing. You wanna grab a little bit of the bagoong. I recommend that you use a spicy bagoong because then you can get more balance into the dressing, right? Because now you've got salty. I'm gonna add in a little bit of sweetness now with this beautiful kamigin honey. And can't get over that smell. Fresh honey is always the best. So I'm gonna do about equal parts of honey and bagoong, just to balance it out. And then about 4 parts vinegar. So a lot of this dressing really is about the vinegar, because you have something fried, right? You want something to cut through all of that richness. And that is pretty much it. So I promised a simple recipe and it can't get any simpler than that. Give this a taste. Okay. Still get that bagoong flavor, right? But it's tempered now. A little bit of sweetness, a little bit of sourness. Perfect. Okay, now it's time to cook the shrimp. Okay, this time I want the oil pretty hot, so I have time to get my shrimp and dress it properly. Okay, I have here some beautiful shrimp. I'm just gonna season this simply with salt and pepper. Okay, oil is ready. You want that slight waviness to appear into the oil. And we're good to go. Just drop in the shrimp. We're just gonna let that stay on one side. Now, the oil was super hot a while ago, right? We dropped in the shrimp, the temperature's gonna lower, then we add in our butter so that the butter doesn't burn. Okay, at this point, the shrimp is half cooked. That's the perfect time to add our broth. And this has been simmering for a while now. It has this beautiful color, look at that. And then now, we're just going to let the shrimps fully cook in the broth. Okay, shrimps are fully cooked. That broth slightly thickened. I'm gonna shut it off. And then we're gonna add in the cream. I never cook the cream because it curdles when you add a lot of heat to it. So if you want a really nice smooth sauce, shut off the heat first, then you add in your cream. There. Ooh, this is good, this is good. Nice, once you mix in that cream, the sauce actually looks like a gravy. And I don't really have that much willpower, so I'm gonna taste one. Oh, that's hot. But very good. There's really some nice spiciness in there. Kind of surprised even me. It's probably coming from a little bit from the Worcestershire sauce and some of the black pepper. Oh man, that is really good. I know they're gonna be happy with this.